The online lecture for college students started off with an unusual occurrence. The teacher's camera was turned off due to a supposed malfunction. As soon as the lecture ended, the teacher, Charlie, decided to indulge in his guilty pleasure watching a X video. However, Charlie's solo viewing party was cut short by a sudden jolt of pain in his chest. At first, he thought it was just the excitement of the video, but soon realized it was something more serious. He clutched his chest and groaned in agony. Panicking, Charlie fumbled with his phone, but it slipped from his sweaty palms. Just as he was about to give up hope, a preacher from a nearby sect appeared out of nowhere. Charlie begged the preacher to read one of the essays lying on the table. Maybe it was his way of seeking absolution before the final curtain call. The preacher was taken aback but complied with Charlie's request. However, he also offered to call an ambulance, which was probably the more sensible option. After Charlie's heart attack scare, his friend Liz rushed to his side and was alarmed by his condition. She suggested calling for medical help, but Charlie refused, citing his lack of health insurance and fear of being in debt. The preacher, who was still lurking around, watched the exchange with great interest, probably wondering if he could use it as a recruitment pitch. As Liz helped Charlie to the bathroom, she asked the preacher to leave, blaming his sect for Charlie's poor health. But Charlie seemed more interested in satisfying his cravings than worrying about his well-being. He begged Liz for some fried chicken, which she promptly served him. Later that night, Charlie fell asleep with greasy fingers and a full stomach, dreaming about Moby Dick and his own whale-like physique. The next day, Charlie did some online research about the dangers of obesity and high blood pressure, all while munching on candy bars. Despite his health concerns, he still found time to add some food to the bird feeder outside, proving that he was a kind soul at heart. But as the day wore on, Charlie realized that he couldn't keep living like this. He picked up his phone and made a call, determined to turn his life around. He even managed to take a shower, put on clean clothes, and feed the birds before settling down in front of his laptop. As he typed away, Charlie couldn't help but think about the whale he had read about the night before. Maybe he could be like Ishmael, setting sail on a new adventure, leaving his old life behind. Or maybe he was just delirious from the sugar rush. Either way, Charlie knew he had to make some changes if he wanted to avoid another heart attack scare. As Charlie sat alone in his cluttered house, he heard a knock at the door. To his surprise, it was his estranged daughter Ellie, whom he had left behind when he left his wife. Despite her harsh words and disgust at his appearance, Charlie invited her to sit down and offered to discuss literature with her in exchange for the money he had saved. But Ellie was more concerned with her father's lack of manners, demanding that he stand up and walk over to her without a coaster. When Charlie failed and fell over, Ellie stormed out in a huff, leaving Charlie feeling lonelier than ever. To soothe his worries, Charlie ordered a pizza, but even that couldn't lift his spirits for long. When Liz came to visit and noticed Ellie's forgotten essay on the table, she scolded Charlie for inviting his daughter over against her ex-wife's objections and for neglecting his appearance. In an attempt to cheer him up, Liz offered Charlie a giant hot dog, but disaster struck when he started choking on a piece of the bun. Luckily, Liz was quick to act and helped her friend dislodge the obstruction, even picking up the fallen food from the floor and returning it to him. Feeling grateful but still troubled, Charlie stumbled upon a picture of his old friend on a bookshelf. The memory stirred up emotions within him, and he felt the sudden urge to explore the locked room where he kept all of his memorabilia. But despite his best efforts, he couldn't find the key to unlock the door and eventually gave up on the idea. As he sat alone once again, Charlie couldn't help but wonder what would become of him. Would he continue living like this, drowning in his own misery and neglect? Or would he find the strength to turn his life around, despite the odds stacked against him? Only time would tell. Meanwhile, Ellie grudgingly kept her promise to visit her father, but it was clear that her heart was not in it. She spent most of her time glued to her phone, while Charlie played the role of a grammar Nazi on her essay. Despite his best efforts to start a conversation, Ellie was about as interested in her dad's life as a cat is in vegetables, which left him feeling pretty low. Finally, Ellie broke down and shared her feelings about her dad's absence from her life. She couldn't forgive him for leaving, but she did feel bad for the man for having lost his buddy and gaining a few extra pounds as a result. As they talked, Ellie even probed about Charlie's own heart attack, but he shut down the conversation and started quoting Shakespeare. Later on, Charlie found himself in the bathroom, bawling his eyes out. He had hoped that the sound of the shower would mask his sobs, but Ellie had heard everything. With a sigh, she went over and reminded Charlie that he was stronger than he thought. It was a touching moment. Ellie's words had a profound effect on Charlie, and he managed to regain his composure. And he returned to his daughter, determined to move forward. There is a knock at the door, and Ellie has to open it. Ellie went to answer it, only to find Thomas, the preacher boy, on the doorstep. The young man had decided to return to the fat man and offer his help. Ellie was curious about where the boy had come from and left him with his father before promising to return the next day for his essay. However, instead of getting down to work, Charlie sat across from the young preacher and launched into a conversation about the end of the world and great literature. Thomas tried to convince the fat man that he had a chance for salvation, but Charlie wasn't having any of it. He asserted that he didn't need any help, and the only way the preacher could be of any use was to get the key under the bed and open the mysterious door. As the conversation continued, Liz returned to her friend with a gift, a wheelchair. However, her anger flared up at the sight of Thomas. Charlie quickly calmed her down by explaining that he had invited the boy to help him. But as the conversation unfolded, it became clear that the preacher boy wasn't just a religious zealot. He was genuinely concerned about Charlie's well-being and offered to lend a helping hand. Charlie finally relented. The armchair was a perfect fit for the fat man, and he happily freed his hands. Excited by his newfound mobility, Charlie's attention was quickly diverted when Liz took Thomas outside for a private conversation. Liz was adamant that the preacher boy not come back, but Thomas declared that he wanted to be Charlie's spiritual advisor because he didn't have much left. Liz shared a tragic story about her family's connection to the religious sect he served. Liz's father was so consumed with religion that he kicked his son out of the house and even let him end his life. Despite the story, Thomas insists, and Liz, forgetting all decency, rudely orders him out of the disabled man's life. The disabled man stepped in and asked her to calm down. After Liz left, Charlie finally made it to the room he had been trying to access all morning, only to find that the chair was too wide for the doorway. Frustrated, Charlie was forced to look down the hallway at the things that were dear to his heart and breathe in the room's familiar scent. Later on, during a pizza delivery, the delivery man revealed his name, which made Charlie feel less lonely. While enjoying his pizza in front of the TV, Charlie stumbled upon his daughter's notebook and found three offensive sentences inside. Despite this, he found it amusing and chuckled, but unfortunately, it triggered another heart attack. To calm himself down, Charlie remembered Ellie's essay about a whale and used it to cope with his panic. When Ellie arrived the next day, Charlie requested that she continue writing, despite her bad mood. He attempted to have a heart-to-heart conversation with her, but Ellie couldn't let go of her resentment towards him and expressed all her penned-up feelings. Charlie tried to see the funny side of things, but it seemed like his daughter's anger was only growing. Perhaps he needed to find a different approach to get through to her. Ellie couldn't comprehend why her father had stopped talking to her 8 years ago, but Charlie confessed that he was scared of being rejected by someone. Despite her anger, Ellie still took care of her father and got him a snack, but warned him that it would be small and free from harmful ingredients. This display of affection made Charlie emotional. Ellie stayed up late and started exploring Charlie's house, but was interrupted by a knock on the door just as she entered a mysterious room. When Thomas, the caretaker, arrived at the house, he was concerned to find Charlie sleeping soundly. However, Ellie admitted that she had given him sleeping pills in his sandwich. The preacher is uncomfortable with the girl's behavior, so he plans to leave and return later, but Ellie, not wanting to lose the company, finds arguments to make her pal stay. Ellie persuades Thomas to try her cigarette, and when he agrees, she snaps a photo. As the preacher takes a puff, the tension in the room eases, and Ellie insists that Thomas reveal the truth about his origins. Cornered, Thomas locks himself in Charlie's secret room and admits to Ellie through the door that he initially joined the cult. However, after growing weary of handing out flyers and playing backup, he stole a significant sum of money and fled. Unbeknownst to Thomas, Ellie is secretly recording their conversation on a tape recorder. At the same time, the preacher is preoccupied with his own interests, rummaging through Charlie's books and examining his personal photographs. Unexpectedly, Liz barges into the apartment, accompanied by Ellie's mother, who gawks at her ex-husband in disbelief. Thomas seizes the opportunity to make his escape, leaving Ellie to confess that she had given her father hazardous pills. Charlie regains consciousness, and Liz has to put him on an oxygen tank. The room begins to talk about the money he offered Ellie for visiting him. Liz becomes very hurt. All this time she has been helping the invalid for free, believing that he has no money because he can't even pay for his own health insurance. Without saying anything, the helper leaves, leaving Charlie to his daughter and ex-wife. Mary asks her daughter to leave, and lastly, Ellie wishes her father a speedy exit. The only person left in the apartment with the invalid is his ex-wife, who immediately pours herself a glass of hot liquor. Her former spouses, Mary and Charlie, were reminiscing about their past together. However, Mary had a confession to make. She had not allowed Charlie to see their daughter, Ellie. She explained that Ellie had grown up to be a mean and cruel person, and Mary was afraid that Ellie's behavior would hurt her father. To support her claim, Mary showed Charlie a social media recording where Ellie had mocked her sick father. Mary quickly ended the topic and expressed her condolences for the loss of Charlie's close friend. She snuggled up to Charlie, and they both tried to recall the happy times they had before their separation. During their conversation, Charlie dramatically declared that his life was over. He begged Mary not to abandon Ellie to a life of fending for herself while he ventured into the great beyond. Charlie was now alone again, and he noticed with unease that the bird buffet he had laid out was in shambles. Suddenly, a delivery guy appeared at his doorstep, bearing a fresh pizza. Charlie shooed him away, but the guy stuck around, looking thoroughly grossed out by Charlie's appearance. Not one to waste a perfectly good pie, Charlie chowed down on both pizzas, drenching them in grease and soda until he felt like a human garbage disposal. He even took out his frustration on the student chat room. Just as Charlie was hitting rock bottom, his friend Thomas walked in and caught him in the act. As the joyful guy spills the beans to the fat guy, he tells him that Ellie had sent pictures and a confession tape to the church, and his friends and parents had forgiven him and were eager for his return. But as the conversation winds down, the young man attempts to steer Charlie towards the right path and quotes a passage from the Bible. Unfortunately, Charlie's bitterness towards God proves to be too strong, and he hands the young man a Bible, demanding to be left alone. In a final act of defiance, Charlie announces to his class that he'll be replaced due to student complaints. Despite this, he reads some of the students' honest submissions aloud. In response to their candor, he turns on his webcam for the first time, surprising the students. To conclude the class, he abruptly ends the session by hurling his laptop against the fridge. Later, Liz returns home and notices Charlie's breathing growing more labored. Despite his worsening condition, Charlie remains adamant about not going to the hospital, and Liz eventually stops urging him. As she comforts him, Charlie softly mumbles about Alan's death. Suddenly, the front door opens, and Ellie bursts in, clutching the essay from earlier. Liz informs her that Charlie is dying, and Ellie demands to speak with him privately. During their conversation, Ellie chastises Charlie as he tries to reconcile one last time. When she confronts him about the rewritten essay, Charlie admits that he replaced it with a critical essay on Moby Dick she wrote in the 8th grade, considering it the most honest essay he's ever read. He asks Ellie to read the essay aloud for him, which she hesitantly does. While Ellie reads, Charlie stands up and attempts to walk toward her without his walker, a feat he had tried and failed to accomplish before. As she finishes reading, Charlie starts to float upwards, enveloped in a brilliant white light. The final scene is a flashback to a family trip to the beach, bringing the story to a close. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more amazing content.